Welcome back from break. We're here now talking about the Soul Train Awards.
I know. The Soul Train Awards. I think it's kind of cute. I don't know much about Soul Train, I have to say. Thankfully, I was born a little too late.
I know, right?
But nonetheless, it was a really huge event, and there was a lot of Hall of Famers, of course.
Yes.
Tonight is the night of Hall of Famers.
Yes.
But there was a lot of Hall of Famers there. I believe it was New Edition, the original R&B band. And they were reunited for a Lifetime Achievement Award.
That's correct, and they got to sing Candy Girl, one of their favorites.
No idea that Bobby Brown was in a boy band from back in the day, and that they were pretty successful, really successful.
Yeah, New Edition was kind of the original concept for a boy band. I mean, there was
All Family, so that was a little bit different. But we're talking about New Edition, a group of friends that got together and sung R&B about
so
girls they like.
Their traditional boy band.
I just want
R&B
to know
style.
But, you know, I have to say, though, I mean, here's a band from so long ago, New Edition.
Yes.
I knew Bobby Brown. I'm still in shock. I didn't know he had his own boy band.
I know.
But how it was so popular back then. How long were they together until they... I know that they ended up doing solo projects down the road.
Correct.
And that was kind of when they all went their separate ways.
I believe they've been together for about 25 years off and on. And,
oh,
you know,
wow.
A lot of them did solo albums.
There's Bobby Brown, Ralph Tresvant, Johnny Gill, and then Belle Biv DeVoe.
So to see that a band like that really kept it together and is even being awarded for a lifetime achievement, I think that's a true testament that, you know, it can be done. They can still last.
Absolutely. I think if you have great singers, people who are talented and who are dedicated to the art at the end of the day, you can truly have a long career in music.
Okay.
It will air November 25th, Sunday at 8 p.m. And you get a pre-carpet red show with Tamara Braxton and Tony Rock, which is Chris Rock's brother. So that should be really funny and good to see before the show. And then, of course, you'll have Cedric the Entertainer host the event.
It's incredible. You know, 30 years of history, 30 years of blood, sweat, and tears. It's beautiful that we're getting our first Icon Award through Soul Train and Mr. Don Cornelius, who gave us the first nationwide exposure. And it's madness in here, you know what I'm saying? It's going down, it's exciting all over the place, but we're just, you know, really thankful to know that all six of us are here to be able to accept our roses and smell our roses, you know, and it's just incredible. Thank you.
Don't touch that remote. We'll be right back with some more interviews from the Soul Train Awards.
It's definitely the dancing. But also being able to see those performers from back in the day. Like, it's just amazing how the looks kind of, you know, come back over and over again. It just recycles itself.
You know, it's an amazing, especially for the U.S. We definitely have had other African Americans. To be the first to break a world record and have your name in the books is amazing. So I plan on going for another 4 years, training for Rio, so hopefully I can do it again.
I love Soul Train from the 70s. I'm a big fan of it. I love the whole movement about it. So by the time I was watching Soul Train, it was people going, you know, hip-hop had his Soul Train by the time I got to it. But yeah, I watched it. I don't really know how to explain it, but it's like a little hip, a little.
I have a single out right now called Find A Way. It's going up the chart, and it's on my own label, Sincere Soul Records. So I'm excited about that because it's a project that I'm doing with Capitol and EMI Records, similar to my buddy Eric Benet over here and Tamia. They've all been having some great success over at EMI, and that is my thing. Back to Cool is a full CD, and it's going to be coming out very soon. Well, I would take you back to like one of the dances that was super popular when I came out in the 90s. That's the Bankhead Bounce.
All of his tuxedos. I just love them.
Oh, he's got a game.
Excited, even to be acknowledged, you know, among SWV, you know, and Johnny Gill, who I grew up listening to, you know, in high school, and then also Eric Roberson, who, you know, we've been doing our thing for a long time, and yeah, so I'm honored. I'm really excited to be here tonight.
If your group has a red carpet event in Las Vegas, call Las Vegas Style TV for coverage.
Say I wanted it all, so I got it all. And I kept yours, and I lost it all, baby. Say, how's the smooth run? See, I was the cool lover, but I had a side. You see, one man falls for more bonds. Take us this train, wasn't pulling out of station.
Something like that.
Well, I got this robot. I'm like, all robot. I'm so sick with the robot. Really. Super
simple.
It happens tonight, just look at me. Champion roboter.
Yeah. I'm honored, though. Anytime. You know, Soul Train allows me to be in the house and have a platform and just share my music. I'm happy. Yeah.
Perform. This one. That's what I was trying to. Man. The Asian lady with hair similar to mine who was breaking it down in the blind. Remember her? Her apples were always on point. She was always there. I got my dance lessons from her.
My music style, I guess, would be R&B. It's with a little pop, so it's like pop R&B. It just really feels good. It has kind of older elements to it, but still meeting today. Just that good music that used to make you feel really good and want to get up and dance. That's what we're trying to do.
The first time the Gap Band played, we played it. My brothers and I was incredible. I was nervous. Of course, Don Cornelius calmed everybody down and assured us it was going to be fine.
I love Don Cornelius for what he did. You know, he was back out on the time when no one was really giving black artists a real platform. And he really, for real, gave, like, you know, Aretha Franklin and Gladys Knight and Pips. People that I look at, like, whoa, wow, you know, a real good platform and a relevant platform. Talking about the music and then the face stuff. Versus, like, I'm just going to go and perform and get off TV. He let them speak. He let them have a voice. So, to me, it was like, this is great. It's, you know, like, I was like, now I can hear things about them. I can speak to, you know, about, I can hear what they're talking about. I know where they're coming from. I know where they're struggling from. It's great.
I'm very excited. It's amazing. I've just literally got off the plane from the UK and stepped out into this. So I'm very honored to be here. And, you know, best international performance is a good one for my song, Alone Together with Marsha Ambrosius, who I'm looking for at the moment. And, yeah, and the Centric Award, which is great because I know Centric have been supporting the video and the song, so it's very good.
What is your favorite Soul Train memory?
I would have to say it's me on Soul Train for the very first time with Forrester McElroy, and I lip synced to the song, and afterwards Don Cornelius came to me and said, "So, young lady, why did they use you in the song?" And I was like, "Well, you know, they asked me to listen to their song, and they heard me rhyme." And you know, I checked out, it was a nice tune. I said tune at 17, tune. Like I was on American Bandstand or some craziness. But in any case, that's one of my fondest memories, standing there on the show and talking to him.
Now, Eric, what is your favorite Soul Train memory?
My favorite, I was just mentioning this, my favorite Soul Train memory is probably one that was not even on camera. It was the first time I ever performed on Soul Train. I had a little private moment with Don Cornelius where he came over to me like right before I performed and just told me how much he loved my music. I was this new artist, didn't a lot of people know who I was, but it was like, look, man, I really love your sound. You know, you keep doing you keep, you know, working on your craft and you're going to be all right in this business. And I mean, that just meant so much to me. And so that's my favorite Soul Train moment.
I think as a little girl watching Soul Train, expecting to see the next big star, on my tubes, and then many, many years later, actually being on that stage myself with Don Cornelius, you know, it's just like popping out of the living room into the TV. That was a come hither moment for me, so I'm so excited to be a part of this.
Thanks for watching. I'm Bianca Pace, and thanks for doing it Vegas style.